Well, it's Thursday, so that means it's time for all the latest entertainment news with Ange Bishop, who joins us once again on the desk. Ange, a bit of a step back in time. I'm kind of liking the young talent time. Diehard fan from the 80s. Yeah.
You have taste and you have judgment. I love your work. Yes, indeed. Channel 10 will step back in time in 2012, bringing back family favourite Young Talent Time, as well as visiting the 70s with Puberty Blues. A new breakfast show will also be in the mix from January.
Program launches for the media and advertisers that are done by each of the major networks each year are a crucial part of the business platform, but they also provide a great insight into what we're going to see on the telly next year. And there are some exciting things coming up.
That's right. You know the movie, and many of you have studied the book. It's time to go back to the 70s with Puberty Blues, the series.
As well, a new drama based on the Milperra bikie massacre called Bikie Wars, Brothers in Arms. Another drama based on Julian Assange and the WikiLeaks saga. So a big drama slate there, and welcoming Lisa McCune to the network, who will star in a new series called Reef Doctors. I spoke to her and Offspring star Asha Keddy about drama for next year.
Both play doctors.
That's right.
Except you're obstetrics, and I'm
Are you as crazy as Nina?
She's a little mixed up. She's divorced, but dealing in kind of venom and science a bit.
Yeah, I love that Lisa's part of the network. Yeah, that's unreal.
I mean, Lisa's someone who obviously we love as Australians, so it'll be great to see her back on our screens.
The drama really excites me. You're working with Screen Time, of course, the Underbelly people. You know, Bikie Wars, I think they'll do fantastic things with that.
This represents our biggest commitment to programming on 10 ever.
Also announced, a breakfast show for Channel 10 next year. It'll be called Breakfast, and one of its hosts will be Dr. Andrew Rochford.
And we're guaranteeing it's going to be different. There's no point giving everybody the same thing at breakfast, so we're going to make sure that when we decide how it's going to look, who's going to be there, what's going to happen, we can guarantee it'll be different.
Well, what 10 will need for breakfast is a commitment. And I think if they can show breakfast the sort of commitment they've shown the 7pm project and 6:30pm with George Negus, there's no reason why in 1, 2 or 3 years' time a really respectable, very, very successful franchise couldn't be built for the network.
But without a doubt, the announcement that got the biggest reaction of the night was the return of a Channel 10 classic, Young Talent Time. And the announcement was made by the creator himself, Mr. Johnny Young.
You know, what was exciting tonight is that the people felt that Young Talent Time feeling, and I think sometimes they forget it. You know, Young Talent Time wasn't just about music. It's about a feeling. It's about the university for young children and to watch them grow up and for them to learn. When, at the end of our presentation tonight, he sang All My Loving, because they kept it till the end, folks. And then he Lachlan Murdoch said, and now the new host of Young Talent Time is Rob Mills. And
I'll be honest.
Fantastic. And everybody put their hands in the air, and it was like a handover.
While I'm away, I'll ride home every day, and I'll send all my loving to you.
And you're allowed to say goodnight, Australia.
Good night, Australia.
Good morning, Millsy, and well done. The Young Talent Time website is now open for people to register their interest, and auditions will kick off in Perth on September 17. To find out more, go to the 10 website, 10.com.au. Three of the stars of Horrible Bosses have been in the country this week to promote the film. I caught up with them to find out if the movie was as much fun to make as it was to watch. Take a listen.
Did I tell you that Parkin tricked me into having a drink at 8 o'clock this morning?
Unless your boss isn't sexually harassing you.
See if this thing's working. Oh! I can make out our little friend right there.
Stop it.
You know, yours doesn't sound that bad.
Congratulations on the film. I was at the premiere last night.
Thank you, Angela. Did you stay till the end?
I did. Were you concerned that there was a scene, you know, like some of the horror films where I might have turned
and walked
out?
Apparently we had a runner. At one point we had a runner. Yeah, they got a little scared in the middle there.
Sure.
It's frightening in the middle when the murders start happening.
There are a couple of terrifying moments, so there's no question.
Peanuts?
That was a peanut butter sandwich. Are you not good with peanuts?
Whoa. Look at this.
What about little jabs? Little jabs?
My boss, who we're planning to kill, is dying in front of you when you saved his life?
Well, that sounds bad when you say it like that.
What it seemed like is that you were three blokes who'd been friends for years and years and finishing each other's sentence. I suppose that's called acting, but it was
reacting.
Really... And what?
And reacting, yeah.
Indeed. But it was really genuine. So congratulations for that. Do you actually hate each other's guts, though? This is what I'd like to know.
Mm. Well, let's just say we are actors.
Yeah.
No, we really, really do. It was very, very fortunate because they don't take that into consideration when they cast movies, surprisingly enough. You'd think that they would because... hopefully, if your viewers agree with you, they will see that the chemistry is part of the enjoyment of the film, and sometimes a very, very important part of it, as it is in this one. And so you would think that they may have their choices at the studio level, and then they'd want to put those guys together in a room and see if they get along. But they don't do that. So we got lucky.
Just look through this window right here.
No, let's ring the bell. If we hear any movement inside, we'll know he's here.
Look through the window.
No, it's not a bad idea.
Right here.
Dude, the chances are he's not even home.
Hey,
I haven't seen any activity in this house.
What are you doing? You're not going to ring the doorbell? Dale.
Do you ever stay and hear the audience's responses? I suppose you've seen the film a few times now. Do Australians laugh in different places to Americans, that sort of thing? Do we have a different sense of humour? Have you had a chance to pick that up?
No, you have very similar senses of humour, I think, speaking the same language and all.
Oh, you reckon we speak the same language, do you?
Yeah, more or less.
We put out the garbage, not the trash. We have the boot of the car, not the trunk of the car.
Right. You have a lift, not an elevator.
Correct. Yeah. There are a few things.
There's a couple of things to get wrong, but for the most part...
Want to explain why you're doing 61 in a 25 zone?
I was drag racing.
In a Prius.
I don't win a lot.
Horrible Bosses opens next week. French film star Gérard Depardieu is in trouble after being caught urinating in a plane in front of other passengers. According to the airline, the incident took place on a Paris to Dublin flight. A friend of France's best-known actor has disputed the claim. He says the 62-year-old had been trying to urinate discreetly into a bottle during a flight delay and his aim was a little off-centre. Hollywood nice guy Tom Hanks has lived up to his reputation. The superstar is reported to have refunded money to a couple at a service station after they told him they didn't like his latest film, Larry Crown. The romantic comedy, which also stars Julia Roberts, has been panned by critics and bombed at the box office. The couple told Hanks the film wasn't that good, so the Oscar winner coughed up the $25 they spent on the movie tickets. If vampires are your thing, why not get married in an exact replica of the wedding dress Bella Swan will wear in the latest instalment of Twilight? Fans will have to wait another 3 months to see the Edwardian-inspired gown, but designer Alfred Angelo is already vowing to copy the dress. Angelo has created copies of Kate Middleton's Alexander McQueen gown and last month unveiled a collection inspired by Disney characters. A trailer for Breaking Dawn Part 1 has been released, but the dress is being kept firmly under wraps. Visitors to the Ekka in Brisbane had a treat last night. The stars of the evening entertainment were the 10 Tenors.
They are 10 Aussie blokes who have taken the world by storm. For 16 years, the troupe, which originated in Brisbane, have been successfully mixing classical music and rock.
Oh, I would do anything for love.
In a blend which has made them a household name, not only here, but overseas.
There's no other tenor group that can do all the music that we can.
During Oprah's recent tour down under, the 10 Tenors performed alongside the Queen of Daytime TV on Whitehaven Beach.
People know about the Tenors, but that's just taken it to another level.
They've just released their 10th album called Double Platinum, but being back home touring here is something extra special.
Yeah, there's something about performing in your hometown. It's really cool.
It's been a busy schedule, packed out concerts in Europe, South America. They've sold 3.5 million tickets worldwide. Then there are the album sales.
We're away about 10, 11 months of the year. We do about 250 shows every year.
One of the oldest tenors, Dion Moliners, reigns from Brisbane.
It's just snowballed into, having crazy fans.
But it's the breadth of Aussie talent which makes the boys unique.
Different styles of singers in the group, music theatre background, opera background, which allows us to branch out and do other kind of music and create our own sound.
That sound creates goosebumps.
I would do anything for love.
As the saying goes, leave it to the experts. Nicholas Boot, 10 News.